Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa believes reviving the Mandatory Reserve Officers Training Corps, or ROTC program, will lessen China's bullying in the Philippine waters. De la Rosa says Beijing's disrespect stems from the country's weak defense, having no credible reserve force. He adds the controversial program will make China go easy with its incursions. The death of University of Santo Tomas student Mark Wilson Chua led to the abolishment of the program in 2001. At present, the bill seeking the revival of mandatory ROTC is still being scrutinized in the Senate. The Armed Forces of the Philippines warns China's Coast Guard it should behave in the West Philippine Sea as Manila vows to continue resupply missions to the BRP Sierra Madre. Katrina Domingo joins us on the line for more. Hi, Kat. Good afternoon.
Hi, Rica. That's right. The Chinese Coast Guard station in the West Philippine Sea should behave. That's the strongly worded statement of Armed Forces of the Philippines spokesperson Colonel Medel Aguilar. He says this is because all of the consequences that would arise from any action or violent action in the West Philippine Sea would be blamed on China and its Coast Guard alone. Colonel Medel Aguilar, in a press conference here in Quezon City, says that the Philippine military will continue to resupply its resupply missions to the BRP Sierra Madre, especially after President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. issued a statement that his administration would not abandon troops stationed in the decaying warship anchored near the Ayungin Shoal. He says, but when asked if the Philippines is already seeking aid from other nations to help breach China's blockade around the area, Aguilar said that he is sure that there are talks, but he is not privy to those discussions as of the moment. If we recall, Rica, last week, several nations rallied behind Manila and condemned China's use of a water cannon against a Filipino vessel sailing within the Philippines' exclusive economic zone. So far, one Philippine Coast Guard ship is assigned to every vessel ferrying supplies to the BRP Sierra Madre. That's according to PCG spokesperson Commodore J. Tariela. Tariela says that the PCG is willing to deploy additional vessels to support the resupply missions to the BRP Sierra Madre, but he underscores that that would depend on the decision of the armed forces of the Philippines leadership. So far, he says the PCG has a 97-meter vessel on standby that can serve as an escort for the resupply mission that is expected to happen anytime this week. So far, Rica, Chinese vessels, including paramilitary boats, have swarmed near the area, with the Philippine Coast Guard data showing that 85% of the 400 foreign vessels in the West Philippine Sea still being controlled by Beijing. Last week, if we recall, AFP Chief of Staff Romeo Bronner said that the Philippines is looking to deploy its own paramilitary fleet to counter China's forces in the West Philippine Sea. But the AFP spokesperson clarified today that this is just one of the military's options. Rica.
All right, thank you so much, Katrina Domingo, reporting live. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. eyeing an agreement with Vietnam on enhanced maritime cooperation in the West Philippine Sea. This comes days after China's water cannon attack on a Philippine Navy resupply mission in the Ayungin Shoal. Marcos, who met with Vietnam's outgoing ambassador to Manila last Thursday, said the agreement would bring the two countries stability as they face common challenges in the disputed waters. The palace did not specify what the maritime deal would entail, but it did note Marcos is open to making similar bilateral agreements with other Southeast Asian nations. The Philippines and Vietnam are among the several countries that continue to challenge Beijing's expansive claims over the South China Sea. Brunei, Taiwan, and Malaysia also present competing claims in the disputed territory. The Chief of Staff of the Armed Forces of the Philippines is asking Congress for a bigger fund for their modernization program. General Romeo Bronner Jr. says this would help the force better protect the country's exclusive economic zone. The House has earmarked around 45 billion pesos for the modernization of the military this year.
Ang panawagan sana namin, lalong-lalo na po sa ating mga congressmen, sa ating mga senador, kung sana po ay mapalaki pa natin yung ating modernization fund.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi kailangan po natin talaga bumili ng mga barko, mm-hmm. bumili ng mga eroplano, and kung posible, kung kakayanin po ng ating budget, bili rin tayo ng submarines. No? Dahil ito po yung mga deterrent pag alam kasi ng isang bansa na may submarine ang isang bansa, natatakot silang lumapit. Sa ngayon, dahil nga wala tayong mga submarines, malayang dumadaan, lumalapit.
Last Thursday, the AFP reported there are over 400 foreign vessels in the country's exclusive economic zone in the West Philippine Sea, 85% of which are Chinese vessels. The Philippine Justice Department preparing to file multiple murder cases against suspended lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. over the deaths of three individuals in 2019. The incidents happened before the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo this year, which was allegedly masterminded by Teves, according to Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla.
There's a lot of evidence that was gathered. This took how many months of preliminary investigation? So, almost 4 months of preliminary investigation. Itong tatlong kasong ito ay kasama sa mga bagay na nagbigay takot sa lahat ng tao sa Negros Oriental.
As for Teves's lawyer, Attorney Ferdinand Topacio, the development is not at all surprising. Topacio also expects more harassment to come to his client. An elderly couple believed to be senior members of a communist group taken into custody for illegal possession of firearms. Karen De Guzman joins us on the line with that story. Karen, good afternoon.
Rica, a couple believed to be high-ranking officials of a communist terrorist group had been arrested for illegal possession of firearms and explosives at Barangay Pizza Teresa Rizal Friday morning. According to PNP CIDG spokesperson Police Major May Ann Cunanan, they received an information that the couple was keeping firearms inside the rented house. By virtue of a warrant, operatives of PNP CIDG and AFP conducted a search inside the house and were able to recover one M16 rifle loaded with 28 ammunition, two pieces of improvised explosive devices, and other evidence such as subversive documents and US dollar bills were also confiscated. Based on the investigation, the elderly man is the Secretary of the National Finance Commission of the CPP-NPA and is in charge of the management of the party's fund. Meanwhile, the woman is a member and comtech of the NFC. CIDG said the couple was behind extortion operations of the CPP-NPA, victimizing different transportation companies and businessmen nationwide. The couple admitted they were former members of the group but denied the allegations, saying that the recovered pieces of evidence were planted by the police. They are facing charges in violation of Comprehensive Firearms and Ammunition Regulation Act and Law on Explosives. Rica?
Karen, a few questions. The couple mentioned, are they related to each other? Any relationship between them?
Yes, Rica. According to the other suspect, that they are married couples.
It seems from the videos we are having that they did not resist arrest. Is that the case that happened?
Yes, Rica, because before the conduct of the search, the search warrant was cleared, was clarified to them that the police officers were going to conduct the said search.
Mm-hmm. Do they have any children?
No, they don't have, Rica.
All right, with that, I'll let you go. Thank you so much, Karen De Guzman, reporting live. An anti-crime group urging President Marcos to enforce an iron fist over the Philippine National Police. This comes after the PNP came under fire after six cops in Navota City killed a 17-year-old boy in a mistaken identity case. The Volunteers Against Crime and Corruption says the PNP and the government must do something to regain the people's trust in the police.
Sure, maraming mag-agree na takot tayo sa police ngayon. Instead na sila yung dapat na lapitan natin, nagdadalawang isip o nagtatatlong isip ang mga law-abiding citizens na lumapit sa kanila. Kailangan, we have to move backward. Marami eh, even before PRRD, nung time ni PRRD, maraming ganito police brutality, no? With yung impunity. Yung process ng sana yung moral valuation at yung spiritual side, no? Ilapit sila sa simbahan, magta sila ng parang theology classes na yung fear of God incorporate sa kanila. Also yung psychological test, yung neuropsycho test yung mga police should undergo dyan. Hindi once a year o once in every 2 years. Ay, dapat yan, quarterly, regular. Kasi nga, yung anger management.
The Marcos administration set to launch a literacy campaign to combat fake news starting next week. The Presidential Communications Office says this will address the massive disinformation and misinformation hounding the country's digital landscape. Giant tech companies such as Google, Meta, TikTok, and X are also expected to collaborate. The new campaign will be integrated into the higher education curriculum, community-based training, and family-oriented programs. Critics of Marcos claim the president himself employed disinformation to revamp his family's name. But Marcos denied these allegations and instead vowed to ensure freedom of expression in the country. The upcoming village and youth council polls will be done manually nationwide, except for some areas in Cavite and Quezon City. That's according to the Philippine poll body. It says two towns in Dasmariñas, Cavite, and the whole District 6 of Quezon City are the only areas that will hold an automated election on October 30. Justifying the move, COMELEC cites a lack of budget.
Wala naman pong budget na binigay sa atin para sa pag-automate ng barangay at FK election. Number two, dahil katatapos nga lang po ng ating election ng 2022, hindi pa po natin kaya kaagad na ipatupad yung automated. Pero hopefully po sa susunod mag-automate tayo.
COMELEC, however, says the 2025 midterm elections will be fully automated.